Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on the gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subjects. And this is lecture number 25. So we are going to solve problems in the Rankine cycle. The earlier two lectures also we solved a problem in the Rankine cycle. So this is additional problems from the gate question paper in Rankine cycle. And before we take up the discussion, so these are all the books I published: Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics, Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on all the subjects mentioned here. And the solution for gate question paper is also uploaded in the YouTube channel for the benefit of mechanical engineering students. So I request you to subscribe the channel and use all the video lectures for your better learning and pass in the gate examination. The first question from 2019 question paper: a steam power cycle with regeneration as shown in the TS diagram employs a single open feed water heater for efficiency improvement. The fluid mix with each other in an open feed water heater. The turbine is isentropic and the input that is bleed to the feed water heater is from the turbine at 2 as shown in the figure. The process 3-4 occurs in the condenser. The input to the boiler is at a state 5. The following information is available from the steam table. The specific enthalpies: H1 equal to 3350 kJ per kilogram, H2 equal to 2800 kJ per kilogram, H3 equal to 2300 kJ per kilogram, H4 equal to 175 kJ per kilogram, H5 equal to 700 kJ per kilogram, and H6 equal to 1000 kJ per kilogram. Now, the mass flow rate of the steam bled from the turbine as a percentage of the total mass flow rate at the inlet to the turbine is at the state 1 is the answer. We have to calculate what is the bleed steam, quantity of bleed steam in percentage of total mass flow rate in the turbine, inlet to the turbine. So, this is inlet to the turbine. So, here we are taking certain quantity of steam for the open feed water heater. The remaining steam is flowing here and getting condensed and mixed with the open feed water heater. So, the answer here is 20%. The how, we will see how in the next slide. And this is what the diagram, TS diagram for the regenerative heater. So, 1 kg of steam flow, 1 kg per second of steam is entering the turbine and flowing up to the 2. And now, at the point 2 from the turbine, m kg of steam is taken for open feed water heating and remaining 1 minus m kg is flowing here. And it is getting condensed. So, at the outlet of the condenser, it is mixed with the open feed water heater. The outlet of 5 open feed water heater, again 1 kg of steam. Now, the enthalpy H1 equal to 3350 kJ per kilogram, H2 equal to 2800. So, H2 is here 2800 kJ per kilogram, H3 is 2300 kJ per kilogram, H4 the enthalpy here saturated liquid 175 kJ per kilogram, H5 again saturated liquid 700 kJ per kilogram, H6 equal to 1000 kJ per kilogram. We have to write the energy balance for the feed water heater. H5 is the outlet of the energy open feed water heater. H5 is the outlet. The inlet is M into H2 plus 1 minus M into H4. So, 1 minus M flow, M 1 minus M kgs per second is flowing through the condenser and it is entering the feed water heater here. So, here rearranging the terms, M into H2 minus H4 plus H4. So, H5 equal to M into H2 minus H4 plus H4. So, substituting numerical values, H5 equal to 700, H2 equal to 2800, H4 equal to 175 and rearranging and calculating M equal to 0.2, that is 20%. So, the amount of bleed steam in percentage, it is only 20%. The next question from 1989 question paper: the layout of a steam power plant working on Rankine cycle with a single stage regeneration is shown in the figure. Assume the exit steam from the regenerator is to be saturated draw the corresponding ideal cycle in the Mollier chart and derive the expression for thermal efficiency of the cycle. So, this is the open feed water heater, single open feed water heater, the turbine, boiler, condenser, pump 1, pump 2. So, at the enthalpy 2, mkg of steam is taken for feed water heating and the remaining 1 minus mkg of steam is flowing free here and it is getting condensed and pumped by the pump to the open feed water heater. The outlet of the open feed water heater, it is taken by the second pump and pumped back to the boiler pressure. Now, the temperature entropy diagram and the enthalpy entropy diagram. So, we have to draw the, assume the exit term, draw the Mollier chart. So, Mollier chart is enthalpy entropy diagram. So, this is the Mollier chart, this is the temperature entropy diagram. So, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, first to pump, 5 to 6, pumping, 5 to 6 is pumping, then 6 to 7, again second pumping, then actually 5 to 6 is heating. 5 to 6 is heating in the open feed water heater, then it is heating, further heating in the boiler 7 to 1. Now, we calculate the turbine work. Turbine work equal to H1 minus H2 into 1 minus H2 minus H3, that is the turbine work. So, 1 into H1 minus H2, 1 minus M into H2 minus H3. The pump work, so the first pump, 1 minus M into H5 minus H4 plus H7 minus H6. Second pump is H7 minus H6. Then the heat supplied, H1 minus H7 and energy balance for the feed water heater. So, this is the feed water heater, H6 is the outlet of the feed water, M into H2 is entering the feed water, 1 minus M into H5 is entering the feed water heater and the energy balance H6 into M into H2 plus 1 minus M into H5. So, rearranging, so H6 equal to MH2 plus H5 minus M into H5. Then M equal to H6 minus H5 divided by H2 minus H5. So, mass of the steam taken for open feed water heating equal to H6 minus H5 divided by H2 minus H5. Then we calculate the efficiency of the reheat cycle, regenerative Rankine cycle, efficiency of the regenerative Rankine cycle, eta equal to net work output divided by heat supply. So, WT minus WP divided by heat supply. So, this is the derivation for the efficiency of the regenerative Rankine cycle. The next question from 1991 question paper, in a single heater regenerative cycle, steam enters the turbine at 30 bar 300 degrees Celsius and condenser pressure is 0.096 bar. The feed water heater is direct contact type which operates at 5 bar. Draw the flow and HS diagram considering the conditions of the steam at the entry to the heater is mixer region. Calculate the steam extracted from the heater to the turbine per kg of steam flow in the cycle. So, cycle efficiency, pump work may be neglected. So, the enthalpy are given, entry to the turbine, entry to the heater, entry to the condenser, exit from the condenser, exit from the heater. So, we have to calculate the amount of bleed steam M in kg per kg of the steam flow and the efficiency of the cycle neglecting the pump work. So, this is the flow diagram of the open feed or single heater regenerative cycle and the corresponding HS diagram. Then we are given this property. So, H1 entry to the turbine 2993.5, H2 exit entry to the open feed water heater 2622.22, entry to the condenser H3 2056.39 and the exit from the condenser. Exit from the condenser H4 188.45 and exit from the heater H6 640.23 and the pump work may be neglected, that is the condition given in the problem. And we write the energy balance for the open feed water heater. So, H6 equal to MH2 into 1 minus MH5. So, H6 equal to MH2 minus 1 minus M into H4, so because H5 equal to H4 for neglecting the key pump work. So, rearranging H6 equal to M into H2 minus H4 plus H4. So, substituting numerical values, 640.23 equal to M into 2622.22 minus 188.45 plus 188.45. So, M equal to 0.186 kilograms per second. Then the turbine work, WT equal to H1 minus H2 plus 1 minus M into H2 minus H3. Substituting all the numerical values, 2993.5 minus 2622.22 plus 1 minus 0.186 into 2622.22 minus 2056.39. So turbine work equal to 771.86 kilo joules per kilogram. And we calculate the heat supplied to the cycle, QS equal to H1 minus H7, which is H1 minus H6, because the pump work is neglected. So, H6 equal to H7. So, substituting numerical values, 2993.5 minus 640.23 equal to 2353.27 kilojoules per kilogram. Then, the efficiency of regenerator Rankine cycle, eta equal to net work output divided by heat supplied. So, WT minus WP divided by heat supplied. So, substitute numerical values, 771.86 minus 0 divided by 2353.27 into 100 equal to 32.8%. Next question from 1992 question paper. So, in a steam power plant operating with a simple Rankine cycle, the turbine is fed with steam at 100 bar and 673 Kelvin. Determine the actual enthalpy and the quality of the steam extracted at 14 bar if the turbine stage efficiency is 90%. So, given data, P1 equal to 100 bar, T1 equal to 673 Kelvin, which is 400 degrees Celsius, P2 equal to 14 bar, and the efficiency of the turbine is 90%, which is 0.9. And the turbine from the steam table at the P1 equal to 100 bar, T1 equal to 400 degrees Celsius, we take the enthalpy of superheated steam equal to 3099.9 kilojoules per kilogram, and entropy S1 equal to 6.218 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from steam table at P2 equal to 14 bar, HF2 equal to 830.1 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 1957.7 kilojoules per kilogram, SF2 equal to 2.284 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and the SFG2 equal to 4.181 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And for isentropy expansion in the turbine, so, S1 equal to S2, so which is SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So, substituting numerical values, 6.218 equal to 2.284 plus X2 into 4.181. So, we calculate X2 equal to 0.94. Then, we calculate the enthalpy at the outlet of the turbine, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 830.1 plus 0.94 into 1957.7 equal to 2670.34 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we define the turbine efficiency. So, turbine efficiency, actual enthalpy drop divided by the isentropic enthalpy drop, H1 minus H2 dash divided by H1 minus H2. So, from this equation, the actual enthalpy of the steam, H2 dash equal to H1 minus turbine efficiency into H1 minus H2. So, 3099.9 minus 0.9 into 3099.9 minus 2670.34 equal to 2713.3 kilojoules per kilogram. So, we have to calculate two parameters. One is the enthalpy at the outlet of the turbine. Another one is the quality. Actual enthalpy and the quality of the steam extracted. So, actual quality is 0.94 and the actual enthalpy is 2713.3 kilojoules per kilogram. Next question from 1995 question paper. Dry saturated steam enters a frictionless adiabatic nozzle with a negligible velocity at a temperature of 300 degrees Celsius. It is expanded to a pressure of 5000 kilopascal. The mass flow rate is 1 kilogram per second. So, calculate the exit velocity. So, the property extract of the steam table is given. So, 300 degrees Celsius, the saturation pressure is 8593 kilopascal. HF value, HG value, SF value, SG value, VF and VG values are given. And similarly, 5000 kilopascal. So, that is 5000 kilopascal. The saturation temperature is 26.91. It is given in the table. And given in the question, and the corresponding enthalpy, entropy in the specific volumes are given. Now, enthalpy at the entry of the nozzle, it is dry saturated steam. It is given as dry saturated steam. So, H1 equal to HG1. So, at the entry pressure, HG1 equal to 2751 kilojoules per kilogram. So, for isentropy expansion, we take S1 equal to S2. So, S2 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So, substituting the numerical values, S1 equal to SG1 5.7081 equal to 2.9206 plus X2 into, we have to substitute SFG2. So, SFG2 equal to SG2 minus SF2. So, 5.935 minus 2.9206, calculating X2 equal to 0.92. Then, we calculate the enthalpy at the exit of the nozzle. So HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. So HF2 equal to at the outlet pressure, HF2 equal to 1154.5 plus 0.92 into HFG2 is HG2 minus HF2, which is 2794.2 minus 1154.5 equal to 2663 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the velocity of the steam at the exit of the nozzle, V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2, which is square root of 2 into 2751 minus 2663 into 1000 equal to 419.5 meters per second. So, the velocity of the steam at the exit of the nozzle is 419.5 meters per second. The next problem from 1998 question paper, a Rankine cycle operates between pressure of 80 bar and 0.1 bar. The maximum cycle temperature is 600 degrees Celsius. If the steam turbine and the condenser pump efficiency are 0.9 and 0.8 respectively, calculate the specific work and the efficiency. The properties of the steam are, we are given the properties pressure 0.1 bar, the condenser inlet pressure and P1 80 bar entry of the turbine and exit of the turbine. So, all the properties are given here and the properties of superheated steam at the entry of the turbine 80 bar 600 degrees Celsius. Specific volume is given 4.486, enthalpy is 3642 and entropy 7.0206. Now, specific enthalpy, what is given? So, look at the diagram. So, this is the simple Rankine cycle. H1 is the enthalpy at the entry of the turbine, H2 is the enthalpy at the exit of the turbine or entry of the condenser, H3 is the enthalpy at the exit of the condenser, H4 is the enthalpy at the outlet of the pump. So, H1 equal to given enthalpy of superheated steam, it is given as 3642 kilojoules per kilogram. H3 equal to HF3, it is outlet of the condenser, saturated water, H3 equal to HF3 equal to 191.9 kilojoules per kilogram. And for isentropy expansion between 1 and 2, S1 equal to S2, which is SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So, substituting numerical value 7.0206 equal to 0.6488 plus X2 into 7.5006. So, calculating X2 equal to 0.85. Then we calculate H2, H2 the isentropic enthalpy, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 191.9 plus 0.85 into 2392.3 equal to 2225.3 kilojoules per kilogram. So, the isentropic pump work Wp equal to H4 minus H3. So, Vf3 into P4 minus P3. So, 0.0010103 into 8000 minus 10 equal to 8.1 kilojoules per kilogram. Actual pump work equal to pump work isentropic work divided by the pump efficiency. So, 8.1 divided by 0.8 equal to 10.125 kilojoules per kilogram. And the H4 dash, the actual enthalpy at the outlet of the pump, H4 dash equal to H3 plus 10.125 equal to 191.9 plus 10.125 equal to 202 kilojoules per kilogram. And the isentropic turbine work equal to Wt equal to H1 minus H2. So, 3642 minus 2225.3 kilojoules, which is equal to 1416.7 kilojoules per kilogram. And the actual turbine work equal to Wt dash equal to isentropic turbine work into turbine efficiency. So, 1416.7 into 0.9 equal to 1275 kilojoules per kilogram. So, heat supplied equal to QS equal to H1 minus H4 dash, which is 3642 minus 202 equal to 3440 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific work equal to turbine, actual turbine work minus actual pump work. So, 1275 minus 10.125 equal to 1264.875 kilojoules per kilogram. And the efficiency of the cycle, actual specific work divided by the heat supply. So, 1264.875 divided by 3440 equal to 0.3677, which is 36.77%. So, thank you for watching. So, you please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video. So, you subscribe the channel for the updated videos on the GATE question paper. You can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So, we'll meet again with additional problems from the GATE question paper in the next video.